Hello, everyone. Welcome back to the Azure AD Architecture Series. We're so happy that we're finally able to shoot these videos again. We did a couple of adjustments, and now we're doing this from home. Hey, Carissa, how are you doing? It's been a while.
It has been a while. Yep. And today I'm super excited because we are going to be talking about Azure AD App Proxy. And it really helps our customers take use of on-premise applications and make the most of Azure AD components like conditional access and sign-in reporting. So I'm very excited to get into this video.
Right. So let's walk through the components that make this possible. Let's start with the remote user over here and the on-premises web applications that we want to access. Fundamentally, we want to achieve a very simple task, to allow the client from an external network to reach this application that's located on premises. For that, we need some public internet-facing URL, and this is where the Azure AD Application Proxy Cloud Service comes into play. This cloud service hosts the endpoints that external clients will reach out to. We call them external endpoints, and they are paired up with a corresponding internal URL or internal endpoint. The app proxy also interacts with the core store over here to map an incoming HTTP request to the underlying application object in the directory and read the configuration so it knows what to do. Here on the right, we'll be walking through the configuration of the application in the Azure portal so you can see how things are going as we complete the picture. Part of the configuration of the external endpoint is the authentication behavior. You can set an external endpoint to be pre-authenticated with Azure AD, which means that the cloud service needs a token and therefore authentication here before even trying to reach back to on-premises. Another option is to configure the external endpoint to be pass-through, which means that the service will just reach back to the on-prem internal endpoint, behaving pretty much like a traditional reverse proxy solution. When you configure the external endpoint to be pre-authenticated, then you are implicitly protecting your on-premises app from malicious traffic patterns such as DDoS, spidering, or any other probing kind of pattern. So customers don't need to worry about additional overhead to mitigate these vectors with on-premises infrastructure. Another aspect that we need to configure is the host name of the external endpoint. By default, Azure AD App Proxy generates something like star.msapproxy.net, but you can also configure a hostname using any of the verified domains in the tenant. We do recommend using the same hostname internally and externally, like we have here, to make sure that users keep a consistent set of bookmarks and also to reduce the chances of the app having dependencies on the hostname, the internal logic that can potentially break the experience at runtime. To enable the name resolution end-to-end, we need to do a couple of things. First, we have to have DNS literally in the picture. We need to configure a CNAME record in your external DNS zone. As you can see, the portal over here shows exactly what to set up in that record. Second, we need the App Proxy Cloud Service to work with ELS, which is why we also need to supply a certificate with the private key.
Okay, cool. So let's look at the components on-premises. First, we have the App Proxy Connector. The App Proxy Connector is a lightweight Windows service that runs on a machine within the on-premises network. And their job is to listen to requests coming from the App Proxy Cloud Service. It's also their job to perform the HTTP requests that the client asks for and to relay the HTTP response back to the cloud service. A key aspect here is that a connector is designed to reach out to multiple connectors. So you don't need a connector per app. It can reach out to multiple. The only thing you need to ensure is that the machine running the connector has visibility to all internal URLs. As other hybrid components in Azure AD, the App Proxy Connector is the one that initiates the network connection to the cloud service to grab initial configuration and to listen for requests. This is an important benefit because with Azure AD, you enable remote access scenarios without heavy infrastructure on-prem, such as a DMZ. To handle scale and high availability, you can just install more connectors, and they load balance the requests coming in without additional configuration. So these connectors can be configured to update themselves. So make sure this is enabled to streamline your operations and treat them as an appliance. Because of this design, it is key that the network channel between the connector and the internal application is performant. Organizations that have multiple data centers or sites with on-premise apps, they can create connector groups and associate the internal application to a specific group. The channel between the connector and the cloud service needs to be very efficient as well. Since the cloud service is built in Azure, customers can take advantage of technologies such as ExpressRoute if available. So now that we have gone through all of this setup, let's walk through an example to see authentication in action.
All right, let's start the flow with Bob here. He needs to access an inventory intranet app over here to see if there are enough hand sanitizer bottles for him to order. For that, he uses a bookmark in his browser. With this setup, the browser will first reach the Azure AD app proxy cloud service in step one. When the request is received by the cloud service, it needs to determine the underlying application configuration based on the URL sent by the client. In step two, the app proxy service looks up in Azure AD application object that has the closest match based on the URL hostname and path. So here in the example, the system chooses the app that has the slash inventory object in the path over here, because it is a better match than the root host, apps.contoso.com, or even the more generic wildcard, star.contoso.com. This behavior allows you to have specialized configuration based on the URL itself, which I personally find very cool and very versatile. Since the app was set up with pre-authentication, the cloud service will redirect the user to the authentication service here in step three. The authentication flow takes place and Bob will be challenged for credentials, MFA, or whatever the configuration of the conditional access is. So what this means is that exactly the same controls that you have for cloud applications are now available for on-premises app as well. After step three is completed, Bob's browser will receive the token and will be redirected to the external endpoint again, over here in step four. The app proxy cloud service will validate the token and it is now ready to reach back to on-prem. In step five, the app proxy cloud service queues up the message for a connector on-premises to relay to the internal on-premises web server. When a connector in the on-prem network picks up a request from the proxy cloud service, it sends the HTTP request to the internal URL here in step six. Once the connector receives the HTTP response in step seven, it will send it back to the cloud service, which in turn sends it back to Bob in step eight. Subsequent requests to the inventory app will reach the app proxy cloud service. And since the user was already authenticated, it will go straight to the app proxy connector and so on and so forth.
All right, so here are the takeaways. With Azure AD, you have a consistent set of tools, such as conditional access. You can manage on-prem and cloud applications the same way when you use pre-authentication. So there is a consistent authorization and authentication policies and experience for your users. Internal apps are not directly exposed to the internet. The connectors on-prem will start outbound communication to the cloud services to receive and process those requests. Azure AD app proxy pre-authentication should be used whenever possible for security and to filter the load to your on-prem app. And one connector can reach multiple applications. It's a good idea to deploy multiple connectors in a connector group for high availability. We recommend three connectors per connector group for load balancing, redundancy, and machine serviceability. Optimize the network traffic between the connectors and the applications and between the connector and cloud services. Set the internal and external endpoints to be the same to have the best experience. And lastly, AppProxy will find the app with the closest match based on the URL, which allows for granular management. In the following videos, we are going to show how you can use Azure AD AppProxy with other types of on-prem applications. So stay tuned for those. You can also find these videos at aka.ms/identityarcvideos. Thanks for watching.
Bye. Thank you for watching.